broadcasting live from the Carter Subaru Studios. You're listening to KIRO Nights. I am G. Scott. Right now, it has been 1 year since the tragic shooting at Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School, where 30 people were shot that day, 17 fatally. That day, Elena Petty, a freshman at the school, was one of those victims that lost their life. Her brother, who is now a senior at the school, joins me now. Patrick Petty, thank you so much for joining me, man.
Thank you for having me on, G.
Yes, sir.
It's a pleasure to be on tonight.
What has the last year been like for you?
The last year has been pretty rough. It's been a lot of ups and downs, and a lot of different emotions as we've sort of investigated the events that led up to and the events that occurred on the February 14th last year.
What are some of the things that have been investigated that has you, I can kind of hear it in your voice, kind of has you kind of disturbed a little bit?
There have been a lot of things, from the police response on the day of, and the police responses to on days prior and months prior to the shooting. There were lots of tips and calls to the local sheriff's department that were never handled. There were two tips to the FBI that were never sent down to the Miami field office and given the appropriate attention that they deserved. And I'm not sure what's been done to fix the FBI side of that, but I do know that I take a little comfort in the fact that the former sheriff Scott Israel has been removed, rightfully so, by Governor Ron DeSantis down here, and replaced with an incredible man in Sheriff Gregory Toney, former police officer in the local city, Coral Springs, here for many years, and opened up his own private security firm, and just a great man, and they has already made some significant changes to the Broward Sheriff's Office down here. Other than that, the negligence of certain faculty members on the day of course, the two security monitors that were fired after the shooting for the negligence on the day of, with letting this shooter walk right onto campus unchecked and not confronting him while being close enough to make out that he was carrying a rifle bag, and what he was wearing, details that you would need to be very close to see, and responses, things that should have been done that weren't done by certain administrators at the school, measures that should have been taken beforehand, and all topped off with a poor response by the superintendent and the Broward School Board, excluding Lori Alhadeff, who, of course, was just elected this last election cycle and lost her daughter, Alyssa. Excluding her, the just an overall poor response afterwards, and poor policy making beforehand by the school board, by the superintendent, and poor implementation of everything, specifically the promise program, the disciplinary program that we have here that really needs to be taken care of, and we need to get rid of that and fix it so that students can be held accountable when they commit crimes in school, and so that we can we can help protect the rights of the 3,500 students more than we protect the rights of one individual that's committing crimes. I think they shouldn't be placed above the safety and security of the other students at a school if they're the ones committing crimes.
We're joined here by Patrick Petty. He is the brother of Alana Petty, who was tragically killed in the Parkland shooting that happened a year ago at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School. And he joins us right here on KIRO Nights. Patrick, can you take us to before the tragic shooting? And what was your high school like before all of this?
Before the shooting, I would describe my high school as the typical high school. There were a lot of kids with all the high school drama that you see, all the high school problems, everything from grades to relationships to little arguments between friends. There were all of those typical things that you think of when you think about high school. And anybody that's been in high school, I'm sure they can relate to what I'm saying. And all of those things, it was your typical high school experience. It was a pretty fun environment to be in, and a pretty fun place to be. I enjoyed going every day and getting to see my friends and my teachers. And as I'm sure many people also agree, the work wasn't my favorite part. The schoolwork's never been my favorite part, but the high school environment I did enjoy.
Patrick, you're still at the school. You're a senior now at the school. What is the school like today?
Now the school, it's very different. There's sort of a struggle between a gloominess that looms because of what happened. There's a struggle between that and love and caring, but from everybody that's from everyone that's there, the students and the teachers there. There's sort of a struggle between those two things, and on any given day, it can be one way or the other. But overall, there's a lot more love and a lot more care and attention for one another, and there's a lot of taking time out of your day just to check on your friends and see how they're doing, and make sure that everyone's doing all right, and help anybody out if they need it. There's a lot of that. We've become a tighter community and a more loving and caring one.
What kind of changes have been made at your school when it comes to security?
With security, there have been a few changes. There are they have new gates and a lot of new cameras that have been put in place. There have been a few policy changes that have been made. Before the shooting, there was nobody that had to be watching the cameras, and the cameras were on. I think if you read the safety report, they were on something like a 26-minute delay, which is just absurd. And now there's always somebody. It's always a live feed. There's always somebody watching the cameras. There are new security personnel, and there are new sheriff's deputies on campus as well, who are just outstanding individuals.
It must be okay and safe enough for you to be there? Because I'd imagine how tough it is to go back to a school in which something so tragic has happened. And we know about the armed sheriff's deputy who resigned in disgrace after it was revealed that he had kind of hidden on campus rather than confronting the gunman. You kind of talked about that, alluded to that a little bit earlier. How's your relationship personally with the new officers that are there?
With the new officers, I love all of them. There's three of them that are stationed there, and then their sergeant and their captain stop by quite often. And I love all three of those guys. They're great individuals. They're great men, and they're there to protect the students. There's no doubt in my mind that if something were to happen, all three of them have told me that they are there to protect, and they are there, and they will run into harm's way to protect all the students of that school. And I believe them. There's not a doubt in my mind that they wouldn't do that, and they're just outstanding individuals, and I'm glad that they're at the school, and they are a big part of the reason that I was okay with going back. Once I met with them and got to know them a little bit, that was a big part of the reason that I was okay with going back this year.
We're joined here by Patrick Petty. Really means world. He joins us. He is from Stoneman Douglas High School out there in Parkland. It's the 1 year anniversary of that tragic shooting. Patrick's sister, Elena, was taken away tragically during that event. Patrick, you're a pro Second Amendment guy. How do you feel about the progress that has been made with our nation when it comes to our gun problem?
I am I am very pro Second Amendment, and after the shooting, I did take time to kind of turn inwards and look at myself and think about that and think if I really was pro Second Amendment still. And I believe that I'm stronger in my belief of the Second Amendment now than I was before, and I think that it's a very polarizing issue, and when I have political debates with people or political conversations, I don't like to start out with that. I like to start with a topic that we can all agree on, and that's what I've been more geared towards, which is school safety and making sure that all the kids come home from school and get back to their parents and loved ones. And when I look at the country today and the way that it's kind of divided over this issue, if I could say one thing to people, it would just be get to know the people that you're having these conversations with. The biggest help in my mind is that I've gotten to know all of the people that I have these political conversations with and gun control conversations with. If I have a conversation with them about that, I like to start off and get to know the person a little bit. It humanizes them. It makes you realize that they aren't a monster just because their views differ from yours. And you don't have to hate them just because they have a different political stance on a certain issue. And so when I, if I could give the country one piece of advice, I would say, let's work on what we can agree on first, get to know each other, realize that we're all human beings and that we're not monsters. We all care about each other. And then we can step out to this polarizing issue of gun control and deal with that. And I think if we get to know each other first and to work on stuff that we all agree on, it builds a bond and it makes those difficult conversations a lot easier to have.
That's powerful right there, Patrick. Very powerful and profound. After high school, what is the plan for Patrick Petty?
The plan for me is hopefully West Point. the United States Military Academy in New York. That's been a dream for the past couple years, and I've always known that I wanted to serve my country, and decided that West Point is the place to be. It is the, in my opinion, the most elite school, and some of the greatest people have come out of that school. Great leaders, great business leaders, presidents, great minds and thinkers. And for me, I'm in the late stages of the application process right there, right now. And hopefully I'll find out sometime in March, April, or May whether or not I get into that academy.
Patrick, I really appreciate you stopping on with KIRO Nights. I have no doubt about it that you are one of tomorrow's great leaders, man. Keep it up, man. My prayers, heart and prayers goes out to both you and your family and all to your classmates in the school and the town of Parkland. Means the world that you stopped on with us, man.
Thank you for having me on. It's been a pleasure, and we really do appreciate all the love and prayers that our family and the Parkland community has been getting. We really appreciate it from everybody.
All right. Have a good one, man. We'll be in touch.
All right.
Take care.
All right. Thank you. You have a great night.
You too. That's Patrick Petty. Man, he is one of tomorrow's great leaders. You can hear it. Coming up next is time to talk to Stacy Joe from 710sports.com. You guys are listening to KIRO Nights. I am G. Scott.